headed to the birthday dinner for Peter and Danelle. We're going to Seasons 52, which Daryl and I went to, and we rated it a 6 out of 10.
Yeah, I know.
I'm going to get the exact same thing, a fillet. 55 grams of protein. I've been saving all my macros today for this meal. What are you going to get?
Same thing.
Seasons 52. Next time we should go to Seasons 53. Daryl and I are king of the castle. Look at this. Daryl. This entire cut, I have been craving pizza. I've not had it once. I've not cheated on my diet once. Flatbread, which is kind of like skinny pizza, right? So it fits my macros. Woohoo! Filet life. And some broccolini. Is that Halo Top?
Yeah.
I've never had that.
You should try some, dude. It's not your birthday. Go,
blow it out, dude. Blow it out. Together, guys. Don't screw up your wish. Wow, okay. Good morning. My hair is super wacky right now. I'm gonna drive into DC because an Uber is $10 to go like 3 miles into the city. Hell no! Take me there, Jeep. Hey, we're in DC. Okay, now it's time to go get a haircut. And boom, we got a fresh cut. Probably have to get another one before all my trips in March. But I've been going to this place to get my haircut for like over a year. In my opinion, it is kind of expensive. Obviously, it's in DC, but I pay close with tip, like close to $50 every time I get my haircut. Obviously, I could go somewhere else that's closer to me, but my opinion, when you find someone that can cut your hair really well and they get how you like it, stay there. All right, now I'm gonna go look for a suitcase at Nordstrom Rack. We are here at Nordstrom because I need to get an actual suitcase, and I keep coming back to this green Tumi one because green is my favorite color and it stands out a little bit and I like it, so I'm gonna get it, okay? Successful trip at the Rack. Pretty satisfied with this bad boy. I know some people are really big fans of like the hard shell, but I like this one. It's ballistic nylon. Tumi's a good brand and I like it, okay? All right, let's get out of here. And we're out of there. Every time that I go into DC, it's like a little motivational boost for me just to continue on with what I'm doing because it's been over 6 months since I left my job. And like even just going in to get a haircut or when I go out even to the bars at nighttime, like I'm walking the same streets that I would walk when I'd go to lunch and like just be like, man, I can't wait till I, you know, actually take that leap and go after what I want. So it's just a cool reminder and it really does keep me motivated. So now let's head home. So the reason that I purchased that suitcase is because I'm gone from Thursday to Thursday, go from Oklahoma straight to Texas. And, you know, normally I would just go for like 3 or 4 days and I'd just bring a duffel bag and that's fine. But because I'm gone so long, I need to bring a lot of clothes. And you might be like, well, Max, just wash your clothes when like you get to Christian's on Sunday. Guys, he doesn't even have an iron. So for me to expect him to have a laundry detergent, I just can't risk that. So I'm just gonna pack a lot more clothes. But either way, I'll pack later tonight, per usual, before I travel, but I'm really hungry, so I'm gonna go pick up some lunch and head to the office to pack some orders and do some emails and be busy, right? Be busy, you guys remember. And we got lunch. Guys, check out Peter's new shoe rack. Tell me that this thing is not basically the shoe version of having four monitors. Why does someone need 20 pairs of shoes at the gym? I have more shoes
at my house that I need to bring. And I gave you, I put my old one here for you to put your shoes in.
That's ridiculous. You know what? Either way, we're gonna eat this and I'll see you at the workout. All right, we're in the gym. Now, I'm doing legs again a day early because when you go and collaborate and hang out and fly, you don't wanna do legs, okay? So I'm knocking that out right now. 235 pounds, 4 sets of 8 on front squats. This is the last leg exercise you'll see for a little bit. Let's do them easily. I'll see you back at my apartment. Oh, what's up, guys? So it is currently very, very late, and I have just finished packing up all of my stuff. First of all, so this suitcase that I bought is amazing. Look how much stuff I fit in here. I have 3 pairs of shoes. I got 2 pairs of NMDs. I got some racers. I got my boots. Then all of my t-shirts are all right here. Belts.
I'm such a noob that like I bought this and I'm like, oh my god, they didn't even give me the key. And then I found out that's for like TSA. But then up here I have all of my joggers and my pants, my socks, my underwear, my stretchy pants, and everything just fits in there. And it's under the weight limit, 30 pounds. I have my outfit for the morning. Pro tip when you travel is wear the stuff that takes up the most amount of room, like the leather jacket. I'm gonna wear this pair of boots and whatnot, so then you don't have to pack that in there. Then I have my carry-on, which has all of my camera equipment. Got some snacks for the morning, my vlog camera, the gimbal, selfie stick, action cam, all the batteries and whatnot. Extra lens, got a 55 millimeter in there. I have wireless headphones. I have a iPad to watch Netflix and stuff. Laptop is already in there. Got my neck pillow. Fun fact is every single time I travel, I always lose my face mask. I just, for some reason, have to buy a new one every single time because I lose it. It is midnight. I have to get up at about 5 o'clock in the morning. So, good night. No cool transition. We're gonna do this transition, actually. Good morning. Welcome to the airport. Let's go ahead and cue the generic airport airplane B-roll footage. Layover in Dallas. I never thought I would say it, but checking the bags so far has been a nice experience. I don't have to lug the duffel around, I just gotta put my backpack on. I can hold more camera gear. It's the best. But it did cost 25 doll hairs to check the bag. That's not the best. 15 minutes till we board for Tulsa. Got myself a Power Crunch bar and a $3 bottle of water. And when I opened this, I forgot that I packed protein bars. Smart Max. Flight's boarding. Let's go. We have landed in Oklahoma. You know, I have flown a million times with this gigantic camera setup, and I've never once had an issue. But on this flight, this one flight attendant was not having it. He was like, you gotta put that under the seat, sir. And I was like, let's put it in my lap. It's gotta go under the seat, sir. Now I gotta go get my bag from the carousel, they call it, not to be confused with the one that you ride with like little pony things. Let's go find my bag. What's up, bro? Oh my god. I didn't know that it... Oh my god. I thought that it was... Look who picked me up. It's your boy, Michael Corey.
Max came all the way. You came to the middle of nowhere for this, man.
Yeah, I expected the Rocky Mountains to be a little rockier, but what movie is that from, dude?
I don't know. Don't put me on the spot like that, dude.
Dumb and Dumber.
I don't know.
You're like Peter.
I don't know.
You know, I got this new bag, but look, it's already getting like banged up, man. The heck is this?
That's what happens, man.
No, I don't want it to be like nice all the time. I don't know if I got it on my other camera, but I dropped this at the airport. It still works though. 2 days ago, Michael said it was like 70 degrees. Now it's
30. Yeah, it's 30. Absolutely freezing. It's miserable.
Thank God I wore this leather jacket.
Yeah.
Michael treated me to the finest that Oklahoma has to offer, flame broiler.
Flame broiler, dude. Don't get it twisted. Way better than Waba Grill. Way better.
It's basically Waba Grill or Teriyaki Madness, but carbon up, and then we're gonna go see the gym. If you guys didn't know, Michael owns a gym. Wow, what an entrepreneur.
Yeah, dude.
This is your gym, dude?
This is my gym.
You own this?
I own it.
I think, you know, just going in there would be too easy.
Okay.
But for my channel, dude, these people need a proper tour right now. We find the light.
What'd you think of that, dude?
Did they know we did two takes?
No, we did like a couple takes. We did two takes and like a walkthrough too.
That was the most cardio that I've done in like a year.
Yeah.
Two takes.
That was essentially the gym, but either way, how big is this gym?
2,500 square feet.
And you have 24-hour access here.
24-hour access. And Christmas.
This is actually the first real setup that you, or this is like the first time it's been officially done because you just now got the cardio equipment in, right?
Yeah, the cardio's in. And then, I mean, everything's pretty much good for powerlifting. It's got all you need, dude.
Wow, dude, sick, dude.
Casa de Corey.
About to go in.
Gated community?
That's how we do it here in Oklahoma, man. I mean, I said we were simple people, but, you know.
VIP life.
VIP.
One flat. You don't have an elevator?
No, dude.
Hold on. Well, we're going to.
I told you, man. We're simple people.
Hold on, dude. This is what you got to do, man.
Bring it through, dude. Come on. I've done that a lot. You just act like, don't look at it, dude.
Don't look at it.
Don't look at it. So can you just go up? No problem. I'll leave it there, dude. We'll get it out the way out. Leave it rolling, dude.
Hold on, dude. Oh, that was such a sick angle.
Did you weigh that out?
No, dude. I offered to weigh some out for you, but you shunned me.
Michael's like, hey, man, when we go out on Saturday, you know, I got these bagel bites for us when we come back. I can't do them on a diet, man.
I'm sorry, man. You could have these though. Some,
no, I don't even know how many. I don't even know how many servings that is.
Just count the triangles, dude.
Some of us are dedicated, man.
13 triangles.
What happened, bud?
It feels like a little damp over here.
Uh huh. Right here.
This looks damp, and dude, I think my cologne exploded.
Oh yeah, definitely a little precipitation on there.
Dude, it's all over this bag.
Is this the only cologne you bought?
Damn it, I bet I got my shoes. It's like soak, feel that, dude.
Man.
Idiot! Oh, wait. Oh my God, it's my hair. That's what it is, dude. This is empty. This was brand new. This entire thing drained out. Dude, it soaked that, man.
Ooh.
Dude, I think these three shirts and my bag sucked up all the juices.
Of course.
Shut up! Maybe I should title this video, It Got Ruined. This could have been bad. It went everywhere. Or I was telling Michael that I wish I had a dog, specifically a girl dog, so then I could have like titled this video, She Hates When I Leave Her. She was so sad I left.
Damn, dude. You should have put everything inside of a Ziploc bag and then put it inside of your carry-on thing.
Well, not everyone. This is a waterproof liner, though. This is supposed to be a waterproof liner.
Well, how well did it work for you, dude?
Did you get the angle, dude?
I got the angle, dude. Come on, listen. You're gonna maybe get a hit. I'm putting up on you. I heard you, Nick. Fine. Know you heard it bad. These goofies got me.
All right, I think I'm actually gonna end this video here. I think Michael's gonna film.
I'm taking over.
He's taking over, so the entire time I'm here, his channel will be the first thing in the description. Go check his channel out. Been friends with him for a long time. But hope you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up. And we'll pick right back up
tomorrow. Or today.
I'm going to film once we go to dinner. Go check his channel out. Link in the description. I'll see you guys later.
Peace.
See ya. I think I'm filming the thumbnail under that. Because America.